this is Netra studying 6th standard reading today's news related to UPSC exams. Before going into the news, I request you all to subscribe our channel. Also like, share and comment my video.
Governance. Aarthika Spandana. Chief Minister of Karnataka has launched Aarthika Spandana program to disburse loans of ₹39,300 crore through various cooperative institutions. Under this scheme, ₹15,300 crore will be disbursed to the agriculture sector, and the remaining sum of ₹24,000 will be earmarked for the non-agriculture. Pax Portugal web portal.
Telangana's Minister of Information Technology and Industries launched the Primary Agriculture Cooperative Society Portugal web portal. This is the first of its kind portal which contains all the details of the loans, loan processes and services offered by the cooperative society. The portal provides the data and information of various services like paddy procurement and others with figures, fixed deposits and lockers. Information related to the finished and upcoming projects such as petrol bunks, godowns, food processing industries, ATMs, office buildings are mentioned on the website. The website also provides information related to various services including paddy procurement with figures, fixed deposits and lockers. The website is available in Telugu and English and regularly provides the latest news and offers related to the society.
Amendment to the Banking Regulation Act 1949. This will bring cooperative banks under the direct supervision of the RBI and bring them under some of the same governance norms as commercial banks. It will also allow the RBI to amalgamate or reconstruct a stressed cooperative bank without first imposing a moratorium, thus protecting the interest of the depositors. The bill replaces an ordinance to the same effect promulgated on June 26. The National Commission for Homeopathy Bill 2020. It seeks to repeal the Homeopathy Central Council Act 1973. National Commission for Homeopathy will also be set up. The commission comprises of 20 members, including a chairperson. The president of the Homeopathy Education Board, the director general of National Institute of Homeopathy, the president of the Medical Assessment and Rating Board for Homeopathy, in addition to other members. The bill promotes national health goals, encourages homeopathy practitioners to use the latest medical research in their work and also to contribute the research, and facilitates maintenance of homeopathy medical register for India. It is flexible to adapt to changing needs and ensures an effective grievance redressal mechanism. Infrastructure. The Central Vista Redevelopment Project. It is a government's plan for the construction of a new parliament building, common central secretariat and revamping of the 3-kilometer long Rajpath. The project also includes the conversion of north and south blocks into museums and the development of the Central Vista Avenue. Tata Group has won the contract for construction of India's new parliament building with a bid of ₹861.90 crore, beating Larsen and Toubro. The new parliament building will comprise halls with a larger seating capacity for the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, and offices for members of parliament, as well as a courtyard, dining facilities and a lung for lawmakers.
The construction is likely to begin after Parliament's winter session and is expected to be completed by the end of 2022.
Environment. Net present value of forests. The Ministry of Mines has requested the Forest Advisory Committee to exempt digging exploratory boreholes from net present value. NPV is a mandatory one-time payment that a user has to make for diverting forest land for non-forest use under the Forest Act 1980. This is calculated on the basis of the services and ecological value of the forest. These payments go to the compensatory afforestation fund and are used for afforestation and reforestation. It depends on the location and nature of the forest and the type of industrial enterprises that will replace a particular parcel of forest. International relations. Human Capital Index. In the latest edition of the World Bank's annual Human Capital Index, India has been ranked at 116th position among 174 countries. The index benchmarks the key components of human capital across countries. India's score has increased to 0.49 from 0.44 in 2018. Singapore topped the score with 0.88, followed by Hong Kong at 0.81 and Japan at 0.80. Basic Exchange and Cooperation Agreement for Geospatial Cooperation. The US is keen that India sign the first last foundational agreement. Basic Exchange and Cooperation Agreement for Geospatial Cooperation. At the next India-US 2+2 NISTREL dialogue. A maritime information agreement is also under active deliberation between India and the US. India has signed three foundational agreements: the Logistics Exchange Memorandum of Agreement, the Communication Capability and Security Agreement, and the General Security of Military Information Agreement. An extension to the GSOMIA, the Industrial Security Annex, was signed at the last 2+. Gilgit-Baltistan. Pakistan has decided to elevate Gilgit-Baltistan's status to that of a full-fledged province. It is an autonomous region now, and with this evaluation, it will become the fifth province of the country. Gilgit-Baltistan would be given adequate representation on all constitutional bodies, including the National Assembly and the Senate. India has clearly conveyed to Pakistan that the entire Union territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, including the areas of Gilgit and Baltistan, are an integral part of the country by virtue of its fully legal and irrevocable accession. The CPEC, which connects Gwadar port in Pakistan's Balochistan with China's Xinjiang province, is a flagship project of Beijing's ambitious Belt and Road Initiative, passes through this region. IBSA Foreign Ministers Virtual Meeting. India, Brazil and South Africa jointly called comprehensive reforms of the UN Security Council at the IBSA Foreign Ministers Virtual Meeting. IBSA is a unique trilateral forum that brings together three of the world's largest democracies, major economies from three different continents that face similar challenges. All three nations are developing pluralistic, multi-religious, multilingual
multicultural and multi-ethnic nations. The tribe leaders also agree to cooperate with international organizations such as African Union Peace and Security Council, UN, etc. Also, ministers agree to extend their support in accordance to Isuvini consensus and Sarite declaration. Agreed on issues such as peace, security, climate change, countering terrorism, multilateral trading system, non-profilization issues, disarmament, and South-South cooperation.
Automatic train supervision. Delhi Metro Rail Corporation launched IATS, the first made in India signaling system. It is an important subsystem of the signaling system for the development of CBTC based signaling technology for metro railway by automatically detecting all trains on a corridor. Along with the GMRC, NITI, NITI Aayog, MOHUA, Bell and Center for Department of Advanced Computing are part of this development. Maglev Trains. Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited has signed a memorandum of understanding with Swiss Rapide AG to Maglev Train projects in India. The MOU will enable the indigenous manufacturing of the state-of-the-art Maglev trains.
Thank you for watching my video. Today's PPT is given in the description box. Hope you all enjoyed our channel. Once again, I repeat, please subscribe our channel. Also like, share and comment my video. See you tomorrow.